Hello, is everybody there? Good evening. It's been a while since I've been on. I've been out of town, out on travel, having fun. So, getting back into talking about water, continuing the talk where we left off, and just giving everybody about a couple more seconds to see if some more people come on. Or I'm still waiting for one more. Okay. Well, I'm going to go ahead and get started. This is about hydration and how to tell if you're dehydrated. And then I've got some more scary stuff that seems to help remind us to keep drinking water. First off, how do you know when you're dehydrated? As I talked last week, or about 2 weeks ago, your body may be dehydrated, but you don't know it. Your mouth isn't dry, you feel fine. But what's happening is your brain, you may be dehydrated. When your brain needs water, it's going to pull it from the rest of your body and keep it for itself and not tell you. So thanks a lot, brain. I needed that. But anyway, because the brain wants to, it's got to at least be functioning to keep you functioning. So it's going to be greedy. So you need to be cognizant that just because you don't feel thirsty, you may still be thirsty. So what's one of the ways that you can tell? And that's with, if you're fatigued or if you get a headache. That happened to me today at my office. I keep a water bottle, and this is a 32-ounce water bottle, and it was about 2 o'clock, and I felt so sluggish. And I looked over, and I still had about this much water, and I normally drink, I'm at least halfway or so. And, kind of embarrassed because knew I was going to talk to you guys tonight about water. And so I started drinking it, but I pepped up and I'm feeling much better now. So anyway, what does happen? Yes, so you do get fatigue and headaches. And what happens is your body starts to slow down your endocrine system, which that's your thyroid gland, your adrenal glands, the pancreas and your male and female organs, where all of those are where your hormones are being produced. And so if those aren't being produced, and you're not going to have as much communication going on in your body, so that's going to make you feel sluggish. And a lot of times we're going to try to treat it if like drinking coffee or drinking tea. I've done that before in the past, or we go get chips and cookies, and so that doesn't work. So just try to treat the problem, drink some water. It's good to set an alarm, not like what I did. But anyway, and there's an author named Darren O'Lean. He wrote a book called Super Life, and he brings up that when you're dehydrated, that you're body fluid becomes like sludge. And that is totally how I felt today. I felt like sludge sitting at my desk. And not only that, your food isn't being processed, and then your enzymes aren't functioning very well, and then that can cause you to be acidic. And you want to be alkaline and not acidic. If you're drinking water and eating a lot of vegetables, that helps you be more alkaline, as to where acidic is. Like if you're dehydrated, have a lot of sugar, and that can put you in a position where you're prone to diseases and some of the bad ones. So we definitely want to be more alkaline. Now, on a long-term basis, what can happen, these things are just short-term today, but on a long-term, it can cause high blood pressure to not have enough water. Because if you think about it, like say you have your blood plasma is, this amount going through your body. And if it doesn't have enough water, I mean, as much water as it should be, it might be much less blood plasma. So your blood vessels are going to constrict. So you don't want to have constricted blood vessels. And that also causes your heart rate to increase. Another thing that it can cause, in the long term, it can affect your DNA. some of the fibers in your DNA, they're called telomeres. They become shortened when you're in a dehydrated state. And so that's changing the structure of your DNA, which you don't want to go down that road. And it also, lack of water, you know, since we know that can cause cancer and other diseases, is lack of water inhibits the release of your body's own internal interferon chemical. You may have heard of that as being treated as a treatment. So your body has its own ability to fight off cancer. So lack of water inhibits that from being in your body. And it does, also lack of water does have other problems, like if you're in pain, that could be a problem, maybe some muscular pain, digestive problems we mentioned a minute ago, migraines, I get migraines once in a while, even depression and allergies. People with sinus allergies need to drink more water. Keep the histamines out of your sinuses. So that's what I have. And if you have any questions, I'm getting ready to post this on Facebook. And then if you can still continue to make comments down below. So I appreciate you guys watching. And we will talk to you later. Have a great evening.